My name is Onya Sanwu. I'm an organizer with the All African People's Revolutionary Party and the All African Women's Revolutionary Union. And this is a video for the comrades at Anticonquista, where I talk about why I believe African revolutionaries should travel to Cuba and also move in solidarity with the Cuban Revolution. I was there as a member of the Venceremos Brigade. The Venceremos Brigade is a solidarity delegation to Cuba that has been happening for 50 continuous years. It was started by youth organizing and living in the United States who wanted to express their solidarity with the Cuban Revolution against the criminal US blockade that has had such a devastating impact on the Cuban economy. It's also meant to be, in addition to being a direct action about anti-imperial solidarity, it's also about a direct action about how people should have the freedom to move across borders regardless of any desires of the imperialists or the bourgeois. So yeah, it's all around a trip about solidarity, a trip about learning, a trip about building with Cuba and Cubans and learning from the Cuban Revolution. So yeah, that's what I was doing, 2 weeks. And I believe that African revolutionaries in particular should travel to Cuba because first and foremost, Cuba has a long and extremely principled history of solidarity with our struggle for liberation on the continent and in the diaspora. They of course gave refuge to Osiris Shakur. They sent soldiers, weapons, funding, training, doctors to anti-colonial struggles all over the continent and all over the diaspora, including Guinea-Bissau, including in Mozambique, including in Azania, also in Grenada, also in Haiti. They also tried to send aid to Africans living in the United States after Katrina, when the US government abandoned them under Bush and the Bush government refused Cuba's aid. And so Cuba basically has had a long, long, long history of moving in solidarity with the struggles of African people. And they do this not because they want access to our sweet, sweet resources or because they're just another entity looking to exploit our labor as African people, but because they understand that our liberation and the liberation of Africa is tied up with their liberation. They understand that the liberation of Africa and liberation of African people contributes to the struggle for global justice. And so they see it as part and parcel of their struggle for liberation. So Cuba represents a nation that engaged in an act of collective resistance and engaged in armed struggle to overthrow capitalism and colonialism on their territory. And then once they had won that armed struggle, they weren't just like, okay, and we're good. Peace. They decided that they were going to share what they had learned and share the meager resources they had as a poor global South country with struggling peoples all over the world, including African people. Cuba is a model of international solidarity, and just to be in a space where people are so committed to justice that they will travel across an ocean, that they will send their children, that they will send their resources to assist other struggling peoples, like a place with that strong a sense of justice and collective self-determination, is extremely inspiring. In addition to that, Cuba is from the future, meaning that Cuba has discovered a way to organize its society around the basic needs of its people, around meeting the material conditions or the material needs of its people that need to survive. So rather than the society like we have in the United States, where it's organized for profit, where like a few sociopathic people of all identities control all the resources while the rest of the people there starve, Cuba has organized our society in such a way that the resources of this once again poor global South country are distributed equally among the people to make sure everybody has healthcare, has housing, has high quality education, has food, has what they need to live and survive and self-determine and organize collectively for power. So it's just really incredible to see a society that's basically organized in the opposite manner from the capitalist order in the United States, that's organized around the needs of the masses of the people, that's organized to make sure that the weakest person or the most vulnerable person has their needs as met as the strongest person or the most productive person. It's just, again, incredibly inspiring. It's the world that we are trying to build. Those of us who are socialist revolutionaries or anti-capitalist revolutionaries in the United States, we have not yet built that, but we have an example very, very close by that we can learn from. And that is under constant attack from the United States. And that's the last reason I want to touch upon, is that we are citizens of a country which is a force for evil throughout the world. The United States squashes the national liberation aspirations, the freedom aspirations of colonized and oppressed peoples all over the world for no other reason than to make sure they have access to exploitable labor and cheap resources to fuel the capitalist machine. If we are people living in the United States, we benefit as first world citizens from that exploitation, from that order. And so it is our responsibility as people living and fighting in the belly of the beast to move in solidarity with other struggling peoples, just the way Cuba has. Cuba's poor as hell. Cuba is under constant attack from the United States, but Cuba still maintains their commitment to international solidarity because they understand it's one struggle with many fronts. And so we, as citizens of a country that is currently attacking Cuba, a model for revolution, a model for socialism actively, we have a responsibility to Cuba and to all oppressed peoples to stand against that, to move against that, to move in solidarity with struggling peoples internationally. So yeah, learn from Cuba, go to Cuba, discover how African Cuba is. I couldn't even touch on that because I wanted to keep this video short, but Cuba is from the future. Cuba is African and indigenous. Cuba is an example to learn from, and Cuba is a model to move in solidarity with. Thank you.